I know the simple way to get rock and roll. I know the simple way to get you out of control. I can manipulate it like a doll. I say.
A few days ago, we have just replaced some parklights in my newly bought Seicento dashboard because it was completely dead. Yeah, so because of those small bastards. But of course, there is a problem now. Yeah, the backlight works really, really good. It's great, right? Yeah, it's working. But this sucker has a mechanically driven speedometer. And of course, this wire that turns the thing on, yeah. There's a problem with that. It's loose and of course it doesn't work, or simply doesn't work properly. And I could of course, let's say, repair that, but who cares? Here's a brand new dashboard, yeah, right? This one is from the multi-point injection engine, and with little soldering you can just put this on. And this one is of course driven electrically from the encoder or whatever.
Yo, Felix, show them writing that some idiot did on the new speedometer.
This is how the idiots in Poland sell their stuff, their car stuff. Well, this one is a good one because it has just a small writing over here, yeah, but most of those things, when you search the internet auctions, will have a very large letters right over here. So the first thing that you have to do is just grab some, I don't know, some polish and just scratch this up.
Morons.
Yeah, morons. Yeah, but anyway, it's gonna be awesome.
Here we go.
Here comes the new.
Good job.
Yeah. Of course the speedometer will probably not work.
You think?
Yeah. Of course it doesn't work. How could it?
Yeah. It would be too easy.
Yeah. Thank you. Well, we can divide the older and newer vehicles into three groups. So the older one won't use ABS at all. But the speed will be sensed in the gearbox, either through the mechanic linkage or through this Hall sensor, whatever. The second group will have the older version of the ABS that doesn't have any speed signal output, and the speed for the gauges will be still using the signal coming from the gearbox. And there is this third option with new vehicles that will use the ABS, and the ABS will then feed this information about the speed to the gauges, usually using the CAN bus. And because we already have this information about speed coming from the ABS, there is no longer a need of sensing the speed in the gearbox, so there will be no Hall sensor in the gearbox, no worm gear here, nothing. Yeah, and here's the problem. When I will change the gearbox in my Seicento, there will be no longer this Hall sensor here, because this is much newer gearbox, but I don't have the ABS right now. I could mount the original ABS, because there was an option for Seicento to have the ABS, but this will be the older type without any speed signal output. Because of that, I've got two options. Either I will install the newer ABS, for example from Fiat 500 that we have over here. Yeah. Here's my beautiful assistant. Okay, so this is the ABS, of course the used one that used to work in Fiat 500. This is a basic model without the ESP. And the problem with that is that it doesn't work. Well, there is some kind of signal coming through the CAN wires, but this is not the CAN bus at all. There is something wrong with that. So either we would have to buy a new one, or there is a second option. Yeah. The second option would be to create a piece of electronics that would act sort of like an ABS. So it will sense the speed of two wheels. Why two wheels? The ABS is actually sensing speed of all four wheels, but that's only for the purposes of controlling the brakes. You could think that you just need a speed of one wheel to be shown on the gauge, but this is not actually the case, because for example, when you're going into the corner, the inner wheel will have a lower speed than the outer wheel, right? So if you would take the speed only from the one wheel, it doesn't matter the left or right, going into the corner, for example into left corner, would give you a different speed than going into the right corner. So ABS is actually taking the speed from at least two front wheels. It will calculate probably the average of that, and this kind of information will then be sent into the gauge. So my circuit, my piece of electronics would have to make the same thing, right? Act in the same way, so take the speed from, for example, front wheels, both of them, calculate the average, and send the speed directly to my magnetoelectric gauge.